1, 2, 3. It's like goddamn 13 damn matches on this damn card.
What we do here is go back, 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 back.
Welcome to the SummerSlam 2017 review done by your boy, the Wildcat J. Troy, and what a SummerSlam it was. There was a shitload of title changes everywhere, galore. And there were some good matches and some great moments that happened tonight. It was about mad matches. So I'm going to break these shits down. I'm going to start this off. I already know this video is about to be long. So let's break this down. So if you're not ready, you better get ready because here we go. We start off with the pre-show, which was the Miz-Taraj versus the Hardy Boys and Jason Jordan. This was an okay match. There wasn't too many people in the building. There was a lot of empty seats, but there was still people making their way in. But the Miz-Taraj wins when the Miz hits Jason Jordan with the skull crush finale. So Jason Jordan gets pinned by the Miz. I don't know where the storyline is going. It's probably going to ultimately lead to an IC title match between Miz and Jason Jordan. And Jason Jordan is probably going to pick up the IC title. But I need some more character development with Jason Jordan. He needs to develop some more character. Up next, we got the Cruiserweight title match with Neville and Tozawa. And Neville reclaims his crown. He reclaims his Cruiserweight championship. And this was an okay match. It wasn't better than their match on Monday Night Raw. I think the Monday Night Raw match was better. But Neville, he's the king of the Cruiserweights. I was kind of hoping he would lose. And during the shakeup, he would get drafted to SmackDown. I want Neville fighting like people like KO and AJ Styles. I want Neville versus AJ Styles? Come on, man. I want to see more. Neville needs to... He needs to get out of that division, man. Or I want to see him in different matches other than these Cruiserweight people. We go on to a segment with Elias Sampson. He basically doing his little singing thing that he always do. This guy's fucking awesome. I love this guy. Trash in New York, trash in Brooklyn. Talked about Big E, Jay-Z. Just trashed the whole state of New York. And it was awesome. I loved every second of it. I was laughing my ass off. Man, Elias Sampson, I love this dude. I couldn't stand him in NXT, but I definitely loved him on the main roster. They're doing him right. I'm loving it. Keep that up with the Drifter. We got the Usos versus the New Day, which was my favorite match of the night. Thug Usos, man, I'm Thug Usos. Jimmy Thugs, Jay Thugs. And this was a fantastic match. I loved it from start to finish. This was my favorite match of the night. The right team won. I wanted them Thug Usos, man, them Thug Usos to get them titles back. And you know what? Them Thug Usos got the titles back. Hashtag Thug Usos, man, them Thug Usos. They are just fucking awesome. I love the Usos. I met them a couple days ago at Coney Island. I'm gonna tell you about that in a separate video. They are two awesome dudes, man. I love the Usos. I got way more respect for them. I love them, man. They always have love for the Usos, man. Thank God they won these championships, and I need them to beat the New Day again so they can move on to a different tag team. So now we have the main show, which was Baron Corbin and John Cena, aka the burial of Baron Corbin. That's right, John Cena picks up the win over Baron Corbin, and there was no post-match assault. Baron Corbin didn't snap. He didn't kick John Cena's ass. It was just a flat-out ass-kicking by John Cena, and John Cena has buried Baron Corbin. Hashtag, another hashtag for you guys, pray for Baron Corbin, because it is crazy. I don't know how the hell he can bounce back from this. It's insane, yo. I'm a Baron Corbin guy. I love that dude, man. But it's a damn shame what they're doing to him. I don't know how the hell he's going to bounce back from this. Then we got the next match, which was Natalya versus Nat. No. Oh. It was Natty versus Trin for the SmackDown Women's Championship. This was a okay match. Decent match. And the shocker, Natalya beat Naomi clean. This shocked me because I heard that WWE wanted to keep that title on Naomi longer. But nope, Natty, she beat Trin clean, made her tap out, and we got ourselves a new champion. And I want to say to Natalya, you truly deserve it. I mean, I love Naomi to death, but Natty, you truly deserve it. she's been putting over people forever. Like, she really needed that title. Like, at least one more time before she's done with wrestling, because she helped out WWE a lot, especially with putting over women. So, Natty, I love you. You deserve it. And Naomi, hopefully you don't stay out of the title picture that long. I don't know if you're going to reclaim it or not, but, you know, this is Natty's night right now. So, congratulations to Natty. Move on to Big Show versus Big Cass for Enzo and the Starcade. This match was boring, terrible, that's it. Big Cass won. Let's move on to the next match. We got Rusev and Randy. Now, it was a pre-match assault with Randy Orton getting attacked by Rusev from behind. And just when you think, you know, Randy's weak, and I just thought Rusev was just going to take control. Rusev was going to take control as soon as that bell rang. Nope, duck. Rusev goes into the turnbuckle, RKO out of nowhere. Vicious RKO, god damn. That was a crazy RKO, but Rusev deserves better. That's all I gotta say. He really needed to go over in this match. I really wanted Rusev because he needs a big win. Randy Orton can lose 100 times and his career will still be okay. Randy Orton's career is set. We need to start building people like Rusev up, man, because that dude's a beast. He's no slouch and he can go in the ring and he has a shitload of personality. So we need Rusev to start getting some wins. Hopefully he can bounce back from this. We go on to Sasha versus Bliss for the Women's Championship of Raw. And Sasha wins. This match was boring in my opinion. I didn't like it. It was boring. I wanted Sasha to win. She got her win in Brooklyn. She got her pay-per-view win for the championship. But this match was boring. It sucked. But congratulations to Sasha Banks. But this match was boring. We move on to the Demon King. The return of the Demon King versus Bray Wyatt. Man, it was good seeing Finn Balor doing that entrance again. It looked spectacular, man. Oh, the Demon King. Such a great, great character. I love that character. But this was a fast match. I don't think this match went 10 minutes. The Demon King, Finn Balor beat Bray Wyatt. Demon King stands tall. There was no shocker there. I got something in my eye. We go on to Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose versus Sheamus and Cesaro for the Raw Tag Team Championships. This was a good match. A lot of good spots. Funniest part of the damn match was when they had the beach ball flying everywhere. Cesaro, seen that fall outside into the crowd? He jumped over the barricade, takes the ball, and just rips it. That was freaking hilarious. I was dying. That was funny. I understand why Cesaro did it. They should be paying attention to the ring. I was there one time when they did the beach ball. It's fun. But I understand why Cesaro did it. It was funny. But we get Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose, new champions, new Raw champions. Kind of hoping that we would get a Shield reunion at the end of the show, but we didn't get it. But they became tag team champions, Seth and Dean. Hopefully they hold these titles for a long time. I want to see them versus the Hardys. You know, Sheamus and Cesaro is going to get their rematch. Them versus, there's no tag teams overall. The Revival just went down. I don't know who else they could fight, but congratulations to Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins. I can't wait to see what this title reign is going to look like. We move on to Kevin Owens versus AJ Styles with Shane McMahon as a special guest referee for the United States Championship. This was a decent match. I'm kind of glad that the KO and AJ Styles rivalry is over with. It's ran its course. AJ Styles retained the championship, but the whole time, Shane McMahon was taking bumps left and right. Like, he was falling all over the place. And it was just extra. It was too much extra bumping for Shane. It was just too extra. I didn't really like that too much. He was flying all over the place. It was an okay match. I'm just kind of happy that AJ Styles can finally move on and KO can move on to his match with AJ. No, he can move on to his match with Shane McMahon. Maybe at the next SmackDown pay-per-view or Survivor Series. We have Nakamura versus Jinder Mahal for the WWE Championship. This was an okay match. Jinder Mahal retains the championship due to shenanigans, of course. And the Singh brothers, the bump buddies for Jinder Mahal, taking Kinshasa's left and right. They got their ass kicked, but when Nakamura finally got them out the way, he got hit with the Colossus. And 1-2-3, Jinder Mahal retains. I kind of like this because going into this match, Jinder Mahal and Nakamura didn't really have too much of a story. This match is just made like at least like 2 or 3 weeks before SummerSlam, and there was no real build. for this match. So they finally got a little storyline going on, like Nakamura got screwed. So maybe at the next pay-per-view, Nakamura does win the championship. So don't be too upset yet, Nakamura fans. I can go another month with Jinder Mahal as champion. I have no problem with that. I love Jinder Mahal. So thumbs up for Jinder Mahal. We go on to the main event, which was Baron Corbin. I'm tripping. Braun Strowman, Roman Reigns, Brock Lesnar, and Samoa Joe for the Universal Championship. This match, I'm just going to say it, even though the Usos match was my favorite match of the night, this was match of the night. The Usos match was my favorite match, but this was the match of the night. Braun Strowman was the fucking MVP of this match. He single-handedly took out Lesnar in the beginning of the match, not putting him through one announce table, but fucking two, and just destroying everybody. But Joe and Reigns, they did their thing, but Braun Strowman was the MVP of this match. He did his thing. Brock Lesnar ends up getting stretched out after falling through the second table. And I was kind of hoping he was gone, but I should have known better. Brock Lesnar, I can come back. He comes back, and he ultimately wins the match. He F5s Roman Reigns, and Brock Lesnar is still the Universal Champion. What the fuck, WWE? I am over this shit. Clearly, there is monsters in WWE who can take a spot. Braun Strowman. He did better than Brock Lesnar did in the last few years, in my opinion. Ever since coming back. Braun Strowman was the MVP of this fucking match, and he should have won. Even though I was pulling for Roman, I was pulling for draw. I was pulling for everybody but Brock Lesnar. But I don't get what the fuck does Brock Lesnar got on the damn WWE. Is he fucking somebody backstage? Like, what is going on? Like, why is he holding the belt for this long? Like, look, just don't get me wrong. I have no problem with Brock Lesnar being around, but he doesn't need the championship. He don't need it. If Brock Lesnar was fighting somebody else, maybe I'll be into Brock Lesnar more, but him holding that title is not, I'm not liking that. I'm not feeling that too much. He's not around. I like the champions being around, the main champions. Like Jinder, he's around for SmackDown. I want that Raw champion to be around all the time. Doesn't make the championship special. I don't like when people say, oh, just because you don't see the title, that just makes it special. Fuck out of here, man. I want that title on Monday Night Raw every fucking week, man. This is bullshit. Now we got to deal for at least another month or two with Brock Lesnar being champion. But this is ridiculous. I want that title off of him pronto. But overall, SummerSlam was an okay pay-per-view. It could have been better, but trust me, it wasn't the worst pay-per-view. The Usos match, the main event was good, even though the ending. Congratulations to Natty, Sasha. It was a lot of good things that happened tonight. So, SummerSlam 2017, it wasn't a letdown. The main event outcome was a letdown, but overall, it wasn't a full letdown. I like the pay-per-view. I ain't gonna say it was that bad. But yeah. So, if you like this review, hit it with a thumbs up. Like, share, subscribe, show a brother some motherfucking love, man. And follow me on my social media. That'll be posted after this video dips to black. And I walk my happy ass out of there. And join me on Wednesday morning, well, that's when I post my SmackDown vs. Raw videos, for the next SmackDown vs. Raw video. And until then, my people, hope you enjoy Monday Night Raw and SmackDown. Hope they got something special for us in store for us. But until then, until next time, my people, peace out. We are out of here. Boom!